Was there anything contradictory or wrong or bad in starting a business for the purpose of selling these teachings? So it's an idea that haunted me for quite some time. But I have to say, it doesn't haunt me anymore. I actually feel that the work that we're doing at Sounds True and in the relationships we have with other people to sell the Dharma is an evolutionary movement that is tremendously positive and is creating all kinds of access. So I want to talk a little bit about that. I want to talk about some of the questions I've had and how I've sorted it out. One of the things that I've asked is, why is it that there's so much, Vince introduced this is controversial. Why is it controversial to begin with? What's the big deal? You know, we're producing books and audio programs. We're giving authors royalties. We're charging, $4.99 for, less than a fancy Starbucks drink for 2 hours of incredible downloadable content. So what's the big controversy? And I'm not a historian of religion, so I'm not going, clearly, and I'm not going to speak about this. I mean, I've already talked about my college dropout status. I'm not going to talk about this from a historical perspective. But what does seem to be the case is that this idea of separating the sacred and the profane is something that we see throughout religious history. And that there are certain things that go over here. These things live in the world of spirit. Ideas, practices. Sometimes even we think that human teachers live over here in this realm of spirit and they shouldn't dirty their hands with money. And then we have the world of the profane, the world of matter. Matter, money, earth. We have the world of sexuality. And this is all considered to be separate from the world of the spirit. And this core separation, I have to say, does not make any sense to me, as in zero. Zero sense to me. It's life. It's our sacred world, our sacred life. And to me, there's no separation between this world of sexuality and spirituality and this world of money and commerce and spirituality. The question is, how do we bring it together in a way that is of service? What is our genuine motivation? And I think looking to motivation is really one of the key places to start. Because if our motivation behind anything that we're doing is to aggrandize ourselves, to give ourselves more personal territory, to really reward simply ourselves, that's a very different motivation for engaging in the world of commerce than if you're engaging in the world of commerce from a spirit of service. And if really it's the spirit of service, and I was so moved by this presentation on Kiva, something that I knew nothing about. And I thought I would so much rather that some of my money was put in kiva.org than even some of the socially responsible investments I currently have it in. This would make me more personally in touch with where my money was going. So it was really moving to me. And it was clear in listening to Matt, the spirit of service behind what he's doing, this sense of the interdependence and using the flow of money in the name of service. So I think understanding this question of motivation clarifies how we can work with things that perhaps have been divided and separate, and instead look at an all-encompassing sacred world embrace.